Hey, welcome to a special prison rock edition of The Peaks, with a lineup that includes Elvis Presley, Johnny Cash, B.B. King, BTO, and Steve Earle. So lock yourselves down for the next 5 minutes. We've got a great show. More than a few rock and rollers have been known to cultivate an outlaw image, pushing boundaries and testing society's limits in ways that often land them in trouble of one sort or another. So this week, we decided to explore the relationship between rock and the lockup, exploring that fertile intersection between really bad behavior and really great music.
Just once more, Leadbelly.
Take the American blues pioneer Leadbelly, a perennial jailbird who once did a 7-year stretch for icing one of his relatives. This is the earliest footage you're ever likely to see on Rock Peaks. It's a slightly cheesy recreation of Leadbelly meeting folk music historian Alan Lomax in The Slammer in 1935.
You're a fine songster.
Fast forward a few decades, and the image of prison rock gets indelibly and palatably etched onto the public consciousness via Elvis Presley's celebrated cell block dance sequence, a musical number that's much imitated and often cited as the birth of the music video form. Elvis, of course, was too squeaky clean to play a convincing con. For that role, we turned to his label mate at Sun Records, the man in black himself, Mr. Johnny Cash. Now, during Cash's junkie years, he was incarcerated no less than 7 times, and while never held longer than overnight, he clearly developed a kinship and a familiarity with life on the inside. The pair of prison albums he released in 68 and 69 cemented Cash's reputation as a hard-bitten rebel, and the latter record catapulted him to international fame. Fortunately for us, that classic San Quentin concert was partially filmed by Britain's Granada Television. Here we're watching him perform the eponymous title track for the very first time to a very appreciative, albeit captive, audience.
You warped my soul. Your stone walls turned my blood a little cold. San Quentin made you rot and burn in hell. May your walls fall and may I live to tell. May all the world forget you ever stood. And may all the world regret you did no good.
As the tumultuous 60s drew to a close, conditions in America's jails began to deteriorate rapidly, making prison reform a bit of a cause célèbre for some of the more outspoken countercultural heroes. Here's a rarely seen clip of John Lennon on French TV with his musical response to the bloody Attica State riot of September 1971 that left 39 people dead and a nation outraged.
Shoot the prisoners in the towers, 43 poor widowed wives. Attica State, Attica State, we're all mates with Attica State.
And here, 1 year later, is the magnificent B.B. King, appearing at the Sing Sing Correctional Facility alongside Joan Baez for a Thanksgiving Day benefit concert. The show was hosted by Jimmy Dynamite Walker of Good Times fame, and BB's How Blue Can You Get is a triumph of passion and intensity. He'd later acknowledge it was one of the best performances that he ever gave.
I gave you a brand new Ford,
but you said I went in Cadillac.
I bought you a $10 dinner.
You said, thanks for the snack.
Let you live in my penthouse. You said it was just a shack. I gave you 7 children, and now you want to give them back.
After this point, the Jailhouse Jam became something of a rock and roll cliche, with everyone from Carlos Santana to the Californian punk band Crime performing somewhere on a prison yard stage during the 70s and the 80s. North of the border, can rock legends Bachman Turner Overdrive rolled on in to the Saskatchewan Penitentiary in 1988 to deliver a cell block shaking version of their monster hit, Taking Care of Business. A decade later, Steve Earle visited the Cold Creek Correctional Facility in Tennessee as part of his probation for drug and firearm offenses committed during the depths of his heroin addiction. Surprisingly, MTV elected to broadcast the entire 1996 concert, a daring bit of programming for a network not usually used to taking risks.
In the middle of the night. Alone in the pale moonlight, screams out in defiance. He's got no one to turn to. She can talk to you, turn blue.
Okay, so it's been a bit of a heavy episode of The Peaks. We thought we'd try and end things on a lighter note with an episode of The A-Team from 1985 that stars Rick James, Isaac Hayes, and features, you guessed it, a prison concert. The convoluted plot involves James asking the A-Team to spring Hayes from jail, where he's doing time for falling asleep behind the wheel of his Maserati and killing someone, only he's in danger of being killed himself now for stumbling across the corrupt warden's robbery racket and, well, you get the idea. Check out the episode on YouTube. Here's the immortal Rick James doing Super Freak. I'm Barnaby Marshall. We'll be back next week with a regular edition of Rock Peaks. Yeah.